Been hearing a lot about misinformation lately.
Work it, make it, do it, makes us all the better, faster, stronger.
People are dying because of misinformation.
The lies on social media are distorting people's minds.
As part of a larger attempt to trick and scare voters and basically to sort of whisk them into an alternate reality, right?
Choose your own reality.
Start your tape right now because I'm about to tell you the truth.
You can trust us. We are telling the truth.
And F you if you can't handle the truth. This version of Biden, intellectually, analytically, is the best Biden ever. Not a close second. And I've known him for years.
I know you guys are objective over there, that you just report the news as it is.
Oh, I know. CNN makes it. And I know.
Is that supposed to be a lab line?
I wasn't supposed to be, but I guess it is.
There's nothing to see.
He could have undermined the messaging so much that he can actually control exactly what people think. And that is our job.
No, really, there is nothing to see.
We've seen what it looks like when a society loses the ability to distinguish truth from fiction. You just have to flood a country's public square with enough raw sewage. You just have to raise enough questions, spread enough dirt, plant enough conspiracy theorizing that citizens no longer know what to believe. Once they lose trust in their leaders, in mainstream media, in political institutions, in each other, in the possibility of truth, the game's won.
We will continue to be your single source of truth.
Don't believe the lies on the internet.
Stop spreading these lies and conspiracy theories.
All of these are lies.
Can we trust you?
Yes. Yes.
It's very hard to negate these lies with the truth.
Outright, brazen, dangerous, ludicrous lies.
You gotta face reality head on.
The most obvious reality, the one you can see before you.
What they're seeing on TV and what they're seeing in terms of results is a hoax perpetrated by a cabal.
The deep state.
This new world order.
That is crazy.
Insanity.
It's a lurid delusion. It's a form of madness.
Secret cabal. Pedophile. Here in Washington working to undermine the American people.
And it is trying to censor you.
They're trying to chill speech. They're trying to silence us.
To prevent the world from seeing what's really going on.
Some dark story we're not getting.
Who's really controlling it all?
Who exactly is the they? Think for a second. Who's the they?
The Jews.
Always.
Evil drink the blood of children.
In the Clintons and George Soros and Bill Gates and Anthony Fauci.
Vaccine conspiracy theories. False flag conspiracy theories.
Michelle Obama, the man.
It's a lie. It's a lie. Like 9/11 is an inside job. Sandy Hook was a false flag.
Fake stories of dead children, and it's heartbreaking.
The Oklahoma City bombing. The Boston Marathon attack.
Big lie in election denialism.
This is fabricated. It's made up. It's a lie.
Warming and COVID-19.
Replacement theory.
Population control.
Jewish space lasers.
They can control the weather?
Transhumanism.
A lot of people don't even know what that is, and they shouldn't, because it's insane.
Bizarre.
Outlandish.
Pretty homophobic.
Crazy conspiracy theory. That's the only word for it. Crazy.
Untethered from reality.
A deep, wounded conspiracy nuttiness.
An anti-Semitism adjacent hyperventilation over globalism.
It's completely ridiculous.
Mind-numbing absurdity.
Sheer madness.
Hogwash. Dangerous.
A garbage fire.
Poison.
It couldn't be farther from the truth.
The plain fact is that there's been a complete and total epistemic breakdown among tens of millions of our fellow Americans.
There's a bigger problem here about how we are going to control the channels of communication in this country.
It's become such a pervasive problem that a small industry of fact checkers, like the people here at PolitiFact, is working overtime.
We are in so much trouble. This is dangerous. We can't think anymore in this country. You need controls on this. You need regulation. You cannot let these guys control discourse in this country, or we are headed to hell.
You support the mass deportation of undocumented immigrants. 54% of the country supports it. 42% opposes it. When people are being conned,
by this narrative.
And it's part of our problem, particularly in democracies, in terms of building consensus around any issue. It's really, really hard, much harder to build consensus today than at any time in the 45, 50 years I've been involved in this. Our First Amendment stands as a major block to the ability to be able to just, you know, hammer it out of existence.
There's no guarantee to free speech on misinformation or hate speech, and especially around our democracy.
Not everybody can be a robot polisher.
People need to stop talking about eating dogs and cats.
And we will continue to provide everything you need to know.